Hi, my name is Martin.
And I'm Marie-Louise.
A very warm welcome to the students, the staff and the wider DCU community and everybody watching us online today. Hope you're all keeping safe and well.
We are so honoured to be presenting this lunchtime concert as part of DCU's Lunchtime Spring Series, funded by ainm, DCU's arts and culture platform, and presented by the School of Theology, Philosophy and Music. A huge thank you goes to Dr. Donald Flynn for this invitation to present our selection of Irish traditional music today.
So we're going to start off with a set of jigs into a reel. The first jig is called The Hag and the Purse. The second jig is called Grainne's Jig, written by the brilliant fiddle player and composer Tommy Peoples. And the last tune is a tune called The Flyfisher Reel, a reel that was composed by Jackie Daly. Jackie's a great box player from County Cork. We're joined on this set by two brilliant musicians, Jim Murray on guitar and Demaris Woods on banjo. Hope you enjoy it. Jig is called Aherne's Egg Jig, and the second tune is called The Holly Bush. The first gig I got from the playing of Liz and Yvonne Kane, two brilliant fiddle players from Letterflack in County Galway. And it was written by the great Finbarr Dwyer. Finbarr was an accordion player from the famed Dwyer musical family. He was born in Castletown Bear in County Cork in 1946, and he started playing when he was around 3 years of age, and started composing when he was 9 years of age. Both his parents played accordion, and his dad played the fiddle as well. And unfortunately, he passed away in 2014. The second tune is called The Holly Bush, as I said, and he also composed by Finbarr. And Finbarr composed this tune in St. Bernard's College in Killarney. I'm switching up accordions for this one. I'm going to play it on a BC Paolo Soprani. And this accordion was made probably around the 1930s or 40s, I think. And I'm going to be joined by Jim Murray on guitar and Demaris Woods.
Going to play a slow air called Chaoimhín Bhuartha, which translates into English as the cause or reason for my sorrow. And it's the air of an unrequited love song. And while we don't know exactly who wrote it, it was first published in 1905 by Tomás and Micho O'Malley. And it's a very popular air amongst instrumentalists, with the likes of Willie Clancy and the Chieftains first recording it in the late 50s and early 60s. And I first encountered this tune when I was preparing for one of the Flacio slow air competitions, I think the under 12 or under 15 competition. And I just loved the melody of it, and it has always stayed with me. And only recently, in the last few weeks, I found myself humming it out of nowhere for no apparent reason. So I'm going to perform it now, my version of it, on viola and piano, accompanied by my good friend Michelle Mason on cello. Hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
So the next set we're going to play is a set of slides. The first slide is called Slide the Chaoimhín. The second slide is from the playing of Michael Russell. And the third slide is another tune by Francis O'Connor.
One, two, three, four.
So the next set of tunes we're going to play is a set of reels. The first tune is called the Jug of Punch, and the second tune is called Paddy Fahy's Reel. Paddy Fahy was an incredible composer and fiddler, and he has an amazing collection of tunes. He's from Kilconnell in East Galway, and he'd written about 60 tunes, I think, and he died in 2019 at the young age of 103. I'm joined in this one by Jim Murray and Demaris Woods. all, apologies for our dog Rex mauling that football in the background. He could probably give a few tips to the Kerry footballers the way he holds on to that ball. But anyway, the next tune is called Marzi's Waltz, and this was a tune I wrote 7 years ago for our wedding, and nearly got divorced on the same day after Marie-Louise heard the tune. But anyway, so this is where it's getting a bit soppy now, but anyway. It was originally arranged for a string quartet and a trumpet by a friend of ours called Sebastian Petit, and today's arrangement is for viola, cello and guitar, so performed by Marie-Louise, Michelle Mason, and Jim Murray and myself. Hope you enjoy it. Side here, so basically it was developed around a harmonica, so basically it's the same layout here on the right hand side. So I'm going to play a jig into two reels. I don't have a name for the first one. The second tune is called the Edenderry Reel, and the third tune is called Forget Me Not, written by Larry Redican. And Larry was a great fiddle player and has written some brilliant tunes. He was born in Boyle in County Roscommon in 1908, and he moved to New York in the 1920s sometime. And he lived there for the rest of his life, and he died in 1975. And the story goes that he died after playing a set of reels on the stage in Mineola. So I'm going to be joined by Jim Murray and Demaris Woods. Thank you.
the final set in our programme. Thanks a million to everyone who tuned in today, and again thanks to Dr. Donald Flynn for this invitation to perform.
So to finish, we're going to play a set of hornpipes into a reel. The first hornpipe is called McInerney's Hornpipe. I got this from the playing of the mighty Dermot Byrne from Donegal, and it was Martin O'Connor that wrote this tune, another great box player from Galway. The second tune is the Newcastle Hornpipe. I got this from the playing of another great box player called Derek Hickey from Limerick. And this tune was written by James Hill. And James Hill was a fiddler, and he was a composer and a publican who lived in Newcastle upon Tyne and Gateshead. And he died in 1853 at the very young age of 42. And the last reel is called the Hawk's Reel, and I got this from the playing of Paddy Clancy down in Limerick. And Paddy transposed it up to the key of F and was originally written as a hornpipe as well. And this tune was written by James Hill also. So I would like to thank all the musicians that joined us today: Jim Murray on guitar, Michelle Mason on cello, and Demaris Woods on banjo. And it was an absolute pleasure to work with them. I'd also like to thank Nick McAuliffe from Castle Island in Kerry, who helped me out with all the background information on the tunes. Nicky taught me when I was younger, and he was a huge influence on my music. So thanks a million for listening, and keep well. Thank you.